Listen patiently. We, who are the last men, earnestly desire to communicate with you.
Last and First Man, it's a unique project where Jan managed to create a world that has its own aesthetics. It doesn't have one singular kind of meaning, rather a very specific emotion and atmosphere which you kind of get captivated by. And I think it's broad enough and rich enough that everyone could kind of follow a single element or make their own connections and basically have their own experience and see something new every time you kind of watch it. The way I experience this project is a bit like a three-line counterpoint in which each different line supports the other, but could also be perceived as one single line where you could follow. The three main threads are the narration by Tilda Swinton of Last and First Man, which is a sci-fi book by Olaf Stapledon, which was written in 1930. The second thread would be the Eastern European brutalistic monuments, which was shot beautifully by Sturla. And the third one is the score itself, the music, which feels like its own character. It has its own physical, almost entity. The physical quality of the music kind of resembles a lot of the materiality of the film. The fact that Jan chose to shoot this film on 16mm has to do with the idea of time and the kind of ambiguity of time and space. Last and First Man is a film about humanity. Even though you don't really see any human being on the screen, you could really well feel the presence of them, whether it be from the man-made sculptures of the monuments, whether it be the narrative and Tilda Swinton narration, whether it be the music by its almost like tactile presence and kind of the imperfection and the rawness of the sound, which are clearly also is human-made. For the most important element, I guess, is the human voice, which is something that is so recognizable. In this project, we had the chance to work with Jan's close collaborator, Robert Icke, Aubrey Lowe, Hildur Gudnadottir, and theater voices. Working with them was also meaning that we could create some more abstraction in the human voice and transform it and kind of strip it down a bit, kind of losing its context, whether it be the cultural reference, whether it be language, and sometimes even it's hard to kind of know the gender of the singer. Jan's music was very complex, that there was no one way that it could be perceived. I think he talked to many people in various different levels, and the thing that kind of resonated with me, and I appreciate it, that Jan managed to kind of have sometimes complex or new ideas conveyed in a very straightforward way, a way that kind of spoke directly to someone's experience and emotion. The thing that was really interesting for me to observe and understand, which is, I would say, pretty unique as a composer, is depending heavily on collaborations. Jan was almost like a curator, as he was a composer, and he was curating a amazing group of people, and he knew how to create a situation in which he brought people together to create something totally unique. I think that was also his strength, and sometimes kind of different from what people perceive a composer is, this idea of this romantic notion of like a isolated composer sitting with a pen and paper and a piano, kind of expressing themselves. And I think that was much more like a collaborative effort, and embraced that people close to him. Personally, what the project means for me is very emotional, and it was a very hard task to take on. I have felt like it's been a whole process where I kind of figure out how to express my voice within this project and how to deal with his absence. But the main kind of incentive, the main kind of goal was to finish it out of respect. I think this whole abstraction and game of ambiguity throughout the film creates a lot of this, I call that beyond time feeling. You can really put your finger when this project was made, where it feels like it could be made in the past and might as well be made in the future. And I think that's the unique kind of character and quality of the film, that it's just almost otherworldly.
Duration of humanity, its evolution, and many successive species is but a flash in the lifetime of the cosmos.